Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Erin, and today I'm gonna share a video that's a little bit different than I normally share. I usually share videos on veganism and minimalism and just things that, you know, I feel passionate about. But today, it's also something that I feel passionate about and something that I think needs addressed because a lot of people have debt and they don't know what to do with it, kind of like what I am in my situation. So I figured that the best way for me to kind of deal with it and make a plan is to actually share it and have you guys follow along my journey. And today's video, I'm just gonna give you a brief overview of how much debt I have accumulated in my 36 years and basically what I pay out monthly and then what my plan is going forward to slowly but surely pay off that debt while also being able to have a life. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I actually have my computer right here in front of me and I'm going to share with you how much I owe, where I owe that from. And then I'm gonna go over just my general bills because I don't want this video to be super, super long. So if you are interested in finding out how much I owe and figuring out how to pay off debt along with me, because I'm not an expert at this, I'm going to just be basically showing you my trials, my errors, and yeah, just bringing you along. If you're interested in that, make sure you hit the subscribe button below because I will be uploading once a month and basically just showing you how I did that month and how much I paid off and how much I didn't pay off, what went wrong, what went well, and things like that. So if you're interested in seeing stuff like that, continue watching. All right, so the first thing that I'm going to cover is how much I actually owe. So as you can imagine, this is very difficult for me to actually share because I've shared the number on my Facebook page because I'm just transparent like that, but I don't know who's gonna be watching this. So that's a little bit, I guess, unnerving, but again, I want this to be realistic and this is my debt and yeah, I just kind of have to own it, I guess, and be okay with it in the long run. So now I have student loans like a lot of people my age, and I have two credit cards that I actually had all my credit cards paid off, and then I got two because I was moving and I got them for emergencies like a lot of people say they're going to, and then things came up that I did put on those credit cards, like my dog surgeries, and I had some car issues that came up. So I have two credit cards. I have a medical bill, which actually it might be increasing from what it is now because I had some other issues come up. So I might be increasing this total debt in next month. And then I have a car. And so with my student loans, all my bill, like my Capital One and the car and everything like that, this is how much I owe completely. And that again is with the student loan amount. I owe $182,026 in total debt. it's extremely difficult to say that out loud, obviously, because that's like literally almost $200,000 of debt and I'm 36 years old. Yeah. without my student loans included in that number, so two credit cards, my car, and a medical bill, as of today, March 10th, I owe $25,486. Now again, that might go up next month when some new medical bills come in, but as of now, I owe around $25,500 in debt. So when I'm thinking about how much I want to pay off and like everything, I am honestly right now just focused on everything but the student loans. If I can get all my debt paid off without the student loans or not including the student loans, I will be very, very happy. I would love to just have my student loans and that is it. My student loans are almost $157,000. I don't know if I'll ever pay that off, so I'm not even focused on that right now. I need to focus on paying the things that are manageable. So paying $26,000 or around that is my focus for the time being until that's paid off. That's how much I owe completely, and that is what I'm going to be putting my focus towards, that $26,000 or close to $26,000. Now I want to get into how much I make a month and how much my bills, fixed bills and variable expenses are, and then I'll go into, I guess, kind of my plan. So I bring home, without bonus and like overtime and things like that, I will bring home about $5,350 per month. And again, that is not including extras, which probably will be on every single paycheck. So I bring home around $5,400 a month. And between all my fixed bills, which includes rent, my loan payments, I have financial advisor that puts some money away every month for retirement and all that kind of thing. I have a storage unit, you know, car payment, phone bill. I do have some entertainment stuff. Okay, I have Hulu and Netflix, and then I have Audible because I love listening to books in the car, and internet, my medical bill, and then my credit card payments. And then I'm also including in here groceries, my gas money, Easy Pass, because I live in New Jersey and I pretty much pay a lot in Easy Pass. However, my work pays that, so it kind of evens out. And then dog food. So between my fixed bills and my variable expenses, I am paying out about $4,000 a month. And again, a lot of that is towards the debt. So once my debt is paid off, I would have obviously a lot more left over, and that is the goal. So I have around $1,200 left over after stuff is paid off. Now this might change month to month only because I might be making more depending on that paycheck for the month. And I also am, I just moved to New Jersey. I live right outside of New York City. I don't want to pretty much become a recluse and never go out. So I am going to maybe 1 month spend a little bit more by going out with friends or just spending a little bit more extra money. I don't buy myself clothes or things like that, but I do want to live and enjoy my life as I'm paying off debt. So I'm going to say $1,200 a month, but I might be putting less towards debt or more. It just really depends on that month. So that is the how much I'm making a month and what I'm paying towards and what my plan going forward is to. First, I need to build back up my emergency fund. When I moved to New Jersey, I pretty much blew through all of my savings to get an apartment. The apartment hunt here was kind of a nightmare, so that is what I'm focused on. I'm focused on building up my emergency fund back up to around $2,000. That might be a little bit much for some people, but I'd like to have a cushion knowing that if something were to happen, I do have an older dog. I don't want to rely on credit cards. I want to have that money in the bank that I can use in an emergency. So I'm hoping within the next month and a half to have my emergency fund back up to around $2,000. As soon as that $2,000 is back in my emergency fund, then I'm going to start with paying off my debt. This is where I think some people might disagree with me, some people might agree with me. I know the Dave Ramsey plan, which I follow, really, I love Dave Ramsey and I agree with his plan for the most part. The only thing I don't agree with is paying off, or his thing called the debt snowball plan. I understand where he's coming from and where people get the motivation to pay off the smallest debt, and then you can work your way up and you feel more motivation and encouraged to pay off more debt when you see things disappear. However, I'm paying interest on my credit cards. I'm paying interest on my car. I'm not paying interest on my medical bill. And right now my medical bill is the smallest amount that I have. So it doesn't necessarily make sense to me to pay off my medical bill with 0% interest when I'm literally just throwing money away once a month or every month to interest when I could pay it off sooner and then tackle my medical bill later. So the plan is to work on tackling the cards and my car first because they have the interest, and then go for my medical bill. And I'm not even thinking about the student loans. I will be making minimum payments on that probably for the rest of my life. And how else do I help? What else helps me to save money or to put money away when I'm not even thinking? I actually have a couple apps on my phone that are tied to my bank account that actually kind of sneak money out. And they are the Capital app, the Digit app, and the Albert app. And it's kind of like they're all kind of the same, except for Capital, you have a little bit more of ways to save money, whereas Digit and Albert kind of like analyze your spending habits, and then it takes money out depending on how you spend your money. Whereas Capital, you can say take $20 out a month and put it in this account for whatever, you know, you're saving toward. And that's how I went to Egypt a couple years ago, because it snuck money out and I had it when I needed it. So I'm going to be using those three apps, plus obviously putting money physically, like taking it out and putting it into my savings at the end of every month. I'm not 100% sure, because I'm just now starting a new job where I get paid twice a month. So I have to see how things work out, but that is the goal, and that's how I'm gonna use those three apps. Now, as far as my biggest worry or concern, or I think struggle, is going to be the little day-to-day expenses that tend to add up. Like, oh, I'm just gonna get a cup of coffee or a beverage from the gas station, or I work in hospitals, so, you know, I'm just gonna go down and grab a pop or something. I know that's not the healthiest, but for example, if I'm thirsty and I don't want water, because I don't like water, if I'm doing that a couple times a week, that's obviously going to add up. So I really need to stay focused and try and remember that I'm on a budget. And I might try the envelope system, giving myself so much money, and then once that money is gone, it's gone. So I might try that. I'm not 100% sure yet. If I do, then obviously I will let you guys know. And food is my other, I guess, weakness. I feel like I go through a lot of food, but I think I was wasting a lot too. So I think that now I'm going to try and just go shopping for little batches more often and try and spend as little as possible. And then I will update you and let you guys know how much I'm spending a month on food. That is definitely the biggest struggle for me, is the food. And then just the plan for this series. So I'm going to upload at the end of every month and kind of go on an overview of how much I saved, how much I spent, and how much I was able to pay off in my debt. So I think, I didn't cover this a little bit ago, but there are some things that I'm going to need to get for my apartment that I don't have yet. Because I did get rid of a lot of things, and I moved into a very small apartment, and some of my stuff is in storage. So I will eventually need to replace some furniture items. I currently don't have a mattress, so I'm sleeping on an air mattress, so I will need to get one of those. And I don't have a couch here, so I will be buying a probably cheap couch from IKEA eventually. So I might just save a little bit here and there from each paycheck and not spend 100% of that towards debt. Again, that might not be the best thing, but that's gonna, I think, the best thing for me. And if I change my mind halfway through, then I will let you guys know. Yeah, if I decide to change things up, then you will be the first to know. I hope that you guys enjoy this video. I hope that you want to follow along. If you have any suggestions on how to better save or pay off debt, I would love to hear it. If you want to share your debt payoff experience, please share that below. If you think that, you know, I should be paying off this, if you if you agree with the debt snowball plan, I'm okay with like hearing opinions on that as well. Like I said, I'm not a financial expert and I'm just kind of going with what I think makes logical sense. I am gonna do more research, but that is what I wanted to share with you today. I actually made a video last week and it ended up being way too long, so I think that this is more entertaining. I don't know. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. Again, any comments, positive, even negative, I'm okay with. Yeah, I'm excited to bring you along this journey and share with you how much I'm able to pay off and how long it takes me. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I will catch you in my next video. Bye.